So how are we going to solve the aperture problem? Well, look, the basic idea is the same as before. We have to impose some sort of constraints. But this time, we're going to impose some local constraints to get more equations per pixel. So for example, we talked about maybe we'll assume that locally, right around this point, the motion field is very smooth. In fact, how smooth do we want to assume? How about we assume that it's actually the same value? That is, over a window, we're going to assume that UV is the same value everywhere. So if we were using, let's say, a 5x5 window, so there's 25 pixels, if we were assuming that there was one UV for all of these, the UV for, let's say, the center pixel, that would give us 25 equations per pixel. And here they are. So what we've got here is here's our U and V that we're assuming is the UV of some center pixel. And here we have 25 rows of the derivative of an X and the derivative of Y at each of those 25 points. And these are the gradients dotted with UV equals the negative, and here is the temporal derivatives at each of those points. So I can write that as AD equals B, where D is this displacement vector UV, and B is just this 25x1 vector that is essentially the negative of all the temporal derivatives. Okay? So we have this equation, AD equals B, and it's got 25 equations and two unknowns. All right, well, so that's a little bit of a problem. How do we solve a system when we have more equations than unknowns? Well, we do our standard least square solution. When we have an equation like this, we say, well, we're going to minimize the square difference, okay? And the way you do that is by using the standard pseudo-inverse method. So we multiply A by A transpose, and since A is 25 by 2, A transpose is 2 by 25, so A transpose A is just a 2 by 2, and D is a 2 by 1, and A transpose B is a 2 by 1, and we end up with this equation right here, okay? And these have the terms written out. And these sums are summed over whatever the window is that you're summing over. So if it's 5x5, it would be over all those 25 pixels. And over here, you just have the product of the sum of the product of the image gradient times the temporal gradient. This is what we have to solve. And by the way, this technique was first proposed by Lukas-Kanade way back in the dark ages of computer vision, 1981, which is not quite the dark age, it was the dawning of it. The dark ages were in the 60s. All right. You know, we just did that. We can solve our least squares and come up with a solution. But let's understand exactly what solving this means. Okay. So you remember the aperture problem, right? And so here it's drawn out that the idea is if I have a gradient in some direction, and so this is my little gradient there, all right, so that any UV that's along this line would be an acceptable UV. That is, any UV whose component in the direction of the gradient would be acceptable. And that's what this says, that there's a single equation for that. And that's the equation of a line in UV space.